In this video, I'll be going over the basics of base pairing in DNA and going through a couple of practice questions at the end. So you may know from prior biology courses that adenine pairs to thymine and guanine pairs to cytosine, which can be remembered using the mnemonic of apples in the tree and cars in the garage. But of course, in real life, this pairing does not just look like these little bars that are shown here in the diagram. They actually look like this, with adenine bonded to thymine via two hydrogen bonds. This can be contrasted by guanine being bonded to cytosine by three hydrogen bonds. Because adenine and thymine have less hydrogen bonds, then they are weaker and therefore easier to separate. While guanine and cytosine are stronger and therefore harder to separate due to them having more hydrogen bonds. We can use this information to solve the following practice problem, which states, which of the following pieces of DNA is going to be easier to separate into single-stranded molecules using heat, which breaks hydrogen bonds? And a note here is that heat is often used in different biotechnologies such as PCR and sequencing to break hydrogen bonds instead of an enzyme such as helicase. So we can figure this problem out by simply counting the number of AT pairs and the number of GC pairs. In the first DNA molecule, there are 8 AT pairs. And just for your reference, the pairs are represented where the top strand is bonded to the bottom strand. And there are 5 GC pairs. And in the second DNA molecule, there are 6 AT pairs and 7 GC pairs. This question is asking which molecule is going to be easier to break. And we know from the previous information that the AT pairs are going to be weaker. So we know that more AT pairs will allow for easier separation. So because the first DNA molecule has 8 AT pairs and the second molecule has 6 AT pairs, then the first one is going to be easier to break. For the next example, a problem states there's a segment of double-stranded DNA that is found to have a total of 190 bases. If 60 of those bases are adenine, how many of them are guanine? So to start off this problem, we know that the total number of bases equals the number of A plus the number of T plus the number of G plus the number of C. From the problem, we are given that there is a total of 190 bases, so we'll go ahead and substitute this in later. From the problem, we are also given that there are 60 bases of adenine, and so we can use this information to then find thymine. Because remember that adenine is complementary paired to thymine. And so because of this, there's a 1-to-1 ratio of adenine to thymine. And so because there are 60 adenines, then that means that there must be 60 thymine. And when you add those two up, you'll get 120. And so you can go ahead and substitute that there's 190 bases as the total and 120 bases as A plus T. And so you subtract 120 on both sides, and you're left with 70 is equal to the number of guanine plus the number of cytosine. And in order to find the number of guanine, you can use the same complementary pairing principle that there's a 1-to-1 ratio of G to C. And in other words, that means that the number of guanine will equal the number of cytosine. And so we can go ahead and write that as 2G because they equal each other. And then you can go ahead and divide by 2. And you'll get that the number of guanine equals 35. There are a couple things I want to point out about this problem. First, this question is asking about a piece of double-stranded DNA. If this question were asking about a segment of single-stranded DNA or a piece of single-stranded RNA, then we would not be able to complete this question because we don't have the sufficient information about the complementary pairing. And because of this, we would not be able to determine the amount of thymine and therefore the amount of guanine. And if this were a piece of double-stranded RNA, the only thing that we would change here is that we would be able to find the number of uracil instead of thymine from the number of adenine. The second thing I wanted to point out was that this question included that there were a total of 190 bases and not 190 base pairs. If the question had given that there are 190 base pairs, then that means that there would be 380 bases, because you multiply the number of base pairs by 2, since there are 2 bases in a pair. And you can go ahead and solve for guanine the same as you would if the question were asking with a total of 190 bases, and you would get that guanine equals 130 instead.